Hello everyone and welcome to the Extreme TIG channel. For today's video, we got a 4-inch SCAD 40 carbon pipe. I'm just gonna show you in this video beginner's mistakes. One of my colleagues at work, he's a first year welding apprentice, welder. He's a journeyman pipe fitter by trade, but he's chasing his second ticket. So for the cleanup, in and out couple inches from the edge, nice feather edge. Make sure that your pipe, whatever you're welding on, it's always clean, clean, clean. Especially with the TIG welding, guys, always has to be clean. For the lineup, if you got any high-low, I like to do with my bare hands, always check inside, especially on the smaller diameters. If you got any high-low, check on the four sides. The best way just to find any high-low spot is with your fingers, with your bare hand. But as well, always be careful. Okay, this is, as I said, this is my my partner. He's a pipe fitter, but now he's going for to be a welder. So now he's gonna show me where he struggles the most, and that's on the side going up and on the top part. He said he got issue with the root penetration, always too excessive, big root, lots of grapes. And now he's gonna show me what is he doing, and you can guys see what he's doing. Is he doing good or is he doing wrong? Okay, I already see a couple mistakes, but let's see inside. Oh yeah, we can already see that that root, it's too big. It's getting too big. I try to catch both view. What is he doing outside as well? See, just the way how he holds that torch, the way how he holds that wire. Okay, he's not feeding that wire through his fingers. He's just pushing with his whole hands. He's too shaky with the torch hand. Probably dipping tungsten a lot, poor coordination. Yeah, you can see here has been shaky a lot, and that's what reflects to your root. Like from the outside it's not that bad actually, but inside is what matters the most. Okay, he's now going to try to restart. I told him just to relax, he's too tight, you know, that's why you're too shaky. You have to be relaxed, especially with your hand where you hold that torch and with that filler wire. So let's see closer look. That's a big delays. It's just inclination, burning that rod, delaying to put it, reconnect back again. That's why that puddle is sagging in the middle, as you can see it right, like really clear. Dipping that tungsten in the puddle is what happens when you, when your inclination is bad. You burn too much rod, and then you stay out of the rod, and then it just sticks on the side on the wall. And he's been pushing on the side when he was trying to restart, and then he pushed, no stick out. It's, you can barely weld anything with that stick out. It's definitely not gonna help you. As I said, he's just the first year. He's, this is where he struggles the most, on the side and on the top. So we'll try to fix a couple basic steps. You know, that's a big contamination of that tungsten. The tungsten has to be sharp. This tungsten is not sharp at all. You got lots of filler wire on it. Okay, now he's trying to show me what he's actually trying to do. That was a lay wire technique. He was just trying to do lay wire and just go over it side to side motion. Just gonna give him a little tip, see if it's gonna be any improvement. Dipping technique. Dipping technique is the first technique, first step as a TIG welder, especially on the side and on the top part you want to do. Okay, let's see. It's a little bit improvement in coordination, still delays, shaky again, tungsten contamination, inclination. But overall, a little bit better than his previous attempts on the side and on the top. It's a little bit better. It's not perfect, it's not great, but this is how we learn. This is how we learn, but we have to learn the proper way. TIG welding, it's not easy. It's less beginner friendly than all other welding techniques. As I said, you can't do anything with that tungsten. Tungsten always has to be sharp. No any spatters, no contamination, nice and clean, pointed tip as a needle, and also couple steps. If he was using cup 8, that might be too big cup for him, especially on a 4-inch scale 40. Always check for your parts, guys, before you start welding. Check, are they all tight, not loose? You don't want to have anything loose, all those flex body, head, your handle. We try to do, now we're gonna do with cup size 6. Always check for your gas lens, for your collet, everything. You don't want to have any contamination inside, no spatters on your gas lens net or mesh. As you can see here, for with a cup 6, you can actually go on the top of that groove. It gives you a little bit more steadier hand. You're gonna have a little bit better control when you try to wiggle. If you use a cup 8, especially for beginner, it's not gonna give you good control, especially if you got any cracks on that top, on the front side of that nozzle, which is gonna stuck, and it's gonna be delays, and then you're gonna, especially if you poor with your coordination, that's just gonna affect your root. Okay, so for the dipping technique, as you can see, we can wiggle that nozzle right here. And for dipping technique, this is the best step one with the root on the side and on the top, and with the same thing with the lay wire. So go smaller nozzle or a smaller cup, in this case cup size 6, and let's see. So preheat one side, add wire, preheat other, connect that puddle, and then just dip sides. So this is a 105 amps, 1/8 filler wire, and as I said, tungsten 1/8, and that's it. Just add one side, other side, one side, other side. That's this is the basic, guys. This is really basic of a TIG root, but it works always in everywhere, anywhere, anytime. And as a beginner, this is the first technique you wanna do. As you can see here, that's a big, huge difference. With the dipping technique, you control the amount that you are actually depositing in. And the same with the lay wire. If you wanna do a lay wire technique, same thing. Preheat, connect, and then just hold that wire and go slowly. Just stretch that puddle on both sides, and just keep moving forward. Nothing fancy, guys. Don't be scared. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to make mistakes. This is how you learn. Once you dial in with your travel speed, with your settings, with your amps, with the way how you feed that rod, there's lots of factors that play that role. To coordinate both hands, to feed that wire, the way how you hold that wire, all those parts you got on TIG torch, your tungsten, as I said, stick out, tungsten sharp, try to find a nozzle that's gonna work for you good on the root. Later for filling cap, you can switch the different cup, and the way how you hold the wire. If you hold it up too high, then it's gonna be wiggly, it's hard to control, that's gonna stick on the sides. That's why you want to lower it down. Okay guys, I hope this helped for beginners, and thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Bye.